Good morning, everybody. Happy Women's Day, and welcome to week 10 of this English course on Instagram. First thing we're gonna do this morning is a listening exercise. Watch the next video and try to understand as much as you can, all right?
There's a different vocabulary for men and women in the music industry, right?
Give me an example.
Okay, a man does something, it's strategic. A woman does the same thing, it's calculated. A man is allowed to react, a woman can only overreact.
There's a different vocabulary for men and women in the music industry, right?
Give me an example.
Okay, a man does something, it's strategic. A woman does the same thing, it's calculated. A man is allowed to react, a woman can only overreact.
To watch the whole interview, you can swipe up and I'll see you later. There's something that you really need to know. What is this guy doing? This is not a tampon. This is a tampon. This is a swab or simply a COVID test. Be careful. For Women's Day, I've decided to collaborate with Lilt Milano, which is an organization I've always supported. And I want to tell you why it is so important to me. I don't think I ever told you, but my name comes from my grandma's name. I never got to meet her because she passed away when my mom was really young, and she died from breast cancer. The song I want to share with you today is amazing. It's called I Am Woman, and it really helps me when I'm feeling down. I just kind of sing it loud and feel better. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to your regular Tuesday. Today we're going to talk about some differences between American and British English. Some things, like some objects, can be called in different ways depending on where you are. So now I'll read the list and try to think of the possible translation. British versus American.
British versus American.
In British English, this is called a jumper. How about in American?
This is a sweater.
I call this the underground. How about you, Norma?
Subway.
In England, this is a taxi.
It's a cab.
I call this a sofa. How about you?
Oh, come on, Nellie. This is a couch.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Pronunciation Wednesday. Today, I want to focus on four words that we all pronounce wrong. I mean, I don't know why. It's an Italian thing. Now I'm going to show you those four words. Try to read them out loud. You can record yourself if you want, so you can check afterwards and then watch the video. Four easy words that you might pronounce wrong.
Four easy words that you might pronounce wrong. Number one, It's not Instagram. It's Instagram. Instagram. Calendar, not calendar. What? Club. No, not club. And this color is not purple. It's purple. Purple.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Grammar Thursday. Today, I want to focus on a structure that can be a little confusing. I'm going to ask you a question. What are you good at? What are you good at? Try to answer. You have to be really careful because when you say, I am good at, you have to use the ing form of the verb afterwards. So, I am good at singing. Opposite is, I am not good at running. Or, I am bad. I'm really bad at running. Good morning, everybody, and happy Friday. Today I want to teach you an idiom, but I also want to explain it because I think it's really interesting and I didn't even know about it. The word straw can mean two things. One and two, okay? You can say the last or final straw, and it means this in Italian. Let's see why. The full idiom is the straw that broke the camel's back. Terrible. Okay, but imagine a camel that carries straws in general, carries stuff. If you put one more straw on the camel's back, it breaks because it's just too much. Okay, that's where the idiom comes from. The last straw is like that one more thing that you cannot accept anymore. The train is late again. This is the last straw. I'm gonna buy a car, okay? Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our Sunday quiz. Before you take the quiz, breathe, okay? Don't rush. Take your time.
One. Calendar, two, calendar. One, club, two, club.
I hope you enjoyed this week. Tomorrow we will start a new, very special week together. So if you like this page, please tell someone about it. And I'll see you later, 6:30. Bye.